Namaste students, welcome to RSV Group of Schools YouTube channel. I am Umesh Bharadwaj, your science teacher, and this is my video tutorial on second chapter of 8th science, Microorganisms, Friends and Foe. In this chapter, we will talk about different types of microorganisms, their friendly and foe behavior with us. So let's start first of all with the discussion of term microorganisms. As the name suggests, micro means very small, that cannot be seen by eyes alone. In other words, these are organisms which are very small in size that they cannot be seen by naked eyes. We need microscope to observe them. Hence they are called microorganisms, or in short we can also call them microbes. We can classify the microbes into 5 categories: bacteria, virus, fungi, protozoans and algae. They all are microorganisms. We need microscope to observe them. Now the question is, where do these microorganisms live? Means, where is the habitat? Habitat means the place where they live. And microorganisms are found in variety of habitats. You can find microorganism in ice of Antarctica. You can also find them in desert. You can find them in water. You can find them in marshy land, hot springs, in air, in and on the body of plants and animals. So these are all the habitats where microorganisms are present. Now, how these microorganisms are friendly and harmful for us, that we will study with the help of this flow diagram. First of all, we will talk about friendly behavior of microorganisms. First, soil fertility. The fertility of soil is because of the action of these microorganisms which are present in the soil. The microorganisms present in the soil are responsible for the breakdown of dead remains of plants and animals and convert the organic substances into inorganic minerals, which increase the fertility of soil. Many of the microorganisms are also responsible for fixing atmospheric nitrogen. You must have heard the name rhizobium, which is present in the root nodules of legumes and enrich the soil with nutrients, particularly nitrogen. Similarly, nostoc, anabana, these microorganisms increase nitrogen content in aquatic bodies. So in this way, microorganisms enrich the soil with nutrients and minerals. Making of curd and bread. Curdling of milk is also because of bacteria. Lactobacillus bacteria, which are present in the milk, convert milk into curd overnight. In the same way, yeast is used for the preparation of bread. Third is making of alcohol. The alcohol which is used for the making of alcoholic beverages like beer, whiskey, rum. These alcoholic beverages, along with some medicinal products like cough syrups, tonics and tincture of iodine, they all are prepared from alcohol. And alcohol is prepared by the process of fermentation. Fermentation is the process of conversion of sugar into alcohol by the action of microorganism yeast. The yeast is also used by us in making many edible items at home. We eat bhaturas, we eat bread, that is also made by using these microorganisms. Next is antibiotics. Antibiotics, whose names you must have heard, streptomycin, azithromycin, penicillin, amoxicillin. These antibiotics are the substances which are obtained from specific bacteria and fungi and are used to kill the growth of some pathogenic microorganisms in the body. Means they are obtained from the microorganisms and are used to kill or stop the growth of pathogenic microorganisms in the body. Antibiotics are effective only against bacterial infections, as they block the bacterial pathway by which they make their cell wall. So bacteria have to die. In this way, antibiotics are used. Another important use of microorganisms, rather friendly use of microorganisms, is in the vaccine. Vaccine is the preparation of dead or weak pathogens which actually do not cause disease, but when they are injected in our body, they provoke our immune system for the formation of antibodies. These antibodies protect us from harmful infectious agents. Now we talk about harmful nature, harmful microorganisms, how they are foe for us. The next part of the chapter is foe, that their enemy behavior. Microorganisms are also responsible for spoilage of food. Our food articles get spoiled because of growth of microorganisms on them. Not only this, these microorganisms are also carried by agents like mosquitoes, bees, which infect many people by moving from here and there. They sit on infectious material, infectious agents, virus, bacteria stick to their legs, their wings, and when they move from one place to another, they help in spreading these diseases. Microorganisms, pathogenic microorganisms, are also the cause of number of communicable diseases like TB, tuberculosis, cholera, chickenpox, common cold, and the very common disease that is COVID-19 is also because of these microorganisms, the virus. So these diseases are caused due to microorganisms and are called communicable because they spread from infected person to healthy person. In the next video, I will talk with you different types of diseases caused in plants and animals by these microorganisms. Thank you.